matchup with the Timberwolves. They're going to be feeling the effects of it. Playing that much basketball in that short amount of time really takes a toll.
Here are the five for the Clippers. Patrick Beverley out there with Paul George. Then it's Marcus Morris. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. And it's Zubats in at the five. And for Dallas, we've got Luka Doncic. He's out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Finney Smith in at the three. Leonard with the bucket. Fantastic backcourt facing off tonight in this one, Smitty. Let me ask you, do you think this is a guard-centric league right now?
Kevin, it is. And no matter how tall you are and what position, pretty much 90% of the guys now can dribble, they can pass, they can shoot. Guys that are seven-footers that we're calling guards. That's why I think right now this is a guard-oriented league.
Just two to shoot. And Porzingis gets it to go on the assist by Doncic.
Probably wasn't the shot they were looking for, but they'll take the bucket.
And here's Leonard from three. Kleba with the rebound. And so it's Brunson with it. He brings it up for Dallas. Pass to Doncic. Doesn't go for him.
I mean, you won't see this too often. Getting denied at the rim. He's likely to remember that one.
George, no good. Here's Dallas coming into this having notched a win against the Rockets in their last game.
And you know what, though? Not only did they get to the free throw line a lot, but they converted at a high clip.
Their mindset was really to get to the stripe, and they accomplished just that.
So here is Dallas. Brunson, good.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rag. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be a...
Oh! Oh! Oh!
He went high. That was nice.
It's amazing. Everything Leonard gives you, including the eyes to find the open man.
Brunson kicks to Porzingis. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Okay.
Well, so much of the last few seasons have been lost time for Kristaps Porzingis. That ACL injury and then working back from it in the 2019 campaign, never an easy road to start it.
He's off on the second. Greg, with all the time that Porzingis has missed, it's easy to forget just how dominant he is when he's healthy.
KP is one of the few game-changing talents in our league. He can carry an offense and boost an entire team's defense with his presence on the floor.
Passes it to Kleba. Now, Brunson. Shot clock at six. Outside, Porzingis. Shot clock reset for Dallas. Back to Brunson. And Kleba, now top of the key. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question. Leonard, the pass to Morris. Here's the three. It's rebounded by Dallas, and this is the first season matchup for them against this Clippers team.
And here we go, the first in what will be a three-game season series between the two teams.
Both teams will be fighting hard in all these games. They can't split this series.
It's Porzingis with the ball. He'll bring it up for Dallas. Here's Brunson, got a hand on it.
At the point guard position, Patrick Beverley is a great shot blocker.
And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter. He kicks it to Morris. Shoots over Brunson. And again, it's the Clippers missing.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And his pure defensive effort changed that shot from an easy one to a tough one.
And you know, technically, it's a high percentage look. But this is why we play the game.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space. out on perimeter shooters is so important in today's game.
Greg, you look at the young Luka Doncic. What impresses you the most right now about his game?
Kevin, you just don't see many players his height who can handle and make step-back threes. Also, his confidence. He came into the league never doubting that he could dominate a game. And don't forget about his brilliance as a passer.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles. They defeated the Pelicans in their last
on the offensive end. Overall, they did not settle for bad shots. They were very patient, and that was the difference. It's hard to be patient, I know, but look at the outcome they had. Even though he missed it, this is the exact play your offense is designed to produce.
To the paint, and he bangs it home with one hand.
And how about the vision there from Doncic? Can make the easy pass and also the difficult.
Outside, George. The three. It's rebounded by Dallas. Kleba's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Now here's Brunson. Defended by Beverly. Kleba. No good that time. Great D that time from Leonard. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Outside, George. And George with the stuff.
And I just love the aggressiveness from George. Just slicing apart the defense with that terrific ability to penetrate.
Dallas leading by three. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Rick Carlisle gave me a few minutes to catch up with him. He said efficiency is a buzzword around the league, and that's Kawhi Leonard. He doesn't turn it over, doesn't take bad shots. He can give you 30 and never force a thing. Kevin, that doesn't sound
that Porzingis can have on the defensive end, Greg, cannot be overstated.
The reach and leaping ability he has paired with his timing make him a premier rim protector. And what sets him over the top really is that fearlessness. He will challenge anyone and everyone at the rim.
Electrifying play by Kawhi Leonard. Boy, he is talented. This team relies on him for so much.
Williams against Hardaway. Pass to Doncic. Over George. That's good from Doncic on the assist from Hardaway.
And he's capable of scoring from anywhere, really. Doncic has a strong grasp here of the mid-range.
And the Clippers call time here.
And what was more fun to watch last season than Patrick Beverley checking Kevin Durant?
Patrick Beverley's energy and every night. Obviously, the Warriors' talent won out, but the Clippers made them work every step of the way.
Dallas making a switch here. Cole Steins checked in. Landry Shamet checked in for the Clippers. Yes, that goes in.
Love that by Reggie Jackson. The floater is a natural move for him.
Dallas has gone 0 of 2 from deep here. Curry passes to Doncic. Rebound by Patterson. The Clippers trail. There's Shamet. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist.
Well, the first thought from the D there was to protect the rim, so good idea to take the three in transition.
Curry kicks to Doncic. Back to Curry. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. And Dallas leads by one.
We'll see if they can finally hold on to a lead. It's been back and forth all night.
Both teams putting forth their best efforts right now. This is the kind of game fans pay to see.
And he's a good shooter from outside, but not sure from that deep.
You know, we're seeing players move further and further back to create space, but that does make it a tougher shot.
And Leonard gets it to go.
Aggressive D there, but then again, Kawhi finishes through contact almost as well as anyone.
Elbow shot. That one wide left.
And
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Again, Leonard missing. Dallas shooting in this first 38%. They're looking a bit creaky out there. Dallas shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
At the line.
Okay.
That free throw good from Hardaway. Smitty, here's an interesting question. Over the next 5 years, which player wins the most MVPs?
You know, I think it's Giannis. He's looking like the favorite right now because the way he's playing, he has a possibility to win the MVP now. And then I think also because of his age, he's the one guy. Also, Anthony Davis could catch Giannis. He has that type of talent.
And certainly not lacking in confidence. When Doncic gets these inside looks, he just jumps all over.
Powell against Leonard. Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a 3-second violation. Since taking over the starting role in 2018, Willie Cauley-Stein has lived up to his draft spot of being number 6 grade overall in 2015.
And you knew that a big man like Cauley-Stein would take a few years to develop, but at a legit 7 feet and great length, he is everything you could hope for in a starting center.
Leonard looking around. And it's off the back rim. No good.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
Hardaway passes to Powell. Back to Hardaway. Dishes it to Kerr. Fades back. The rebound by Patterson. And Los Angeles guys shooting 36% in this first quarter, trying to get their bearings. A deep three from Leonard. An absolute bomb from three-point range. Leonard's got 11 points.
Riding the hot hand, and why not? If something's working, keep going to it.
Here's Doncic.
And so confident. Even amongst the trees, Doncic is fantastic at forcing the issue close to the rim.
These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
And he buried a bunch of shots from the stripe in that last game.
The Clippers in the lead. Outside Leonard. Leonard draws the double.
A two-time Defensive Player of the Year, Kawhi Leonard, last season averaged 27 points a game. That's what you call a two-way player.
And he can't get the first one.
With Kawhi, you love his talent, but just as important, you love the basketball IQ and work ethic.
And so it's Doncic with it. He brings it up for Dallas. And the dunk by Doncic.
And he wasn't about to do anything that would get him in trouble there.
Nope, up and in with a one-hand finish, the most basic possible. Jackson drives in.
The flat-out speed of Reggie Jackson. No struggles getting to the rim and then doing something about it when he gets there.
Dallas has gone 0-2 from deep here. On the wing, Hardaway. Good, and the assist goes to Doncic. Doncic has got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Right side, Leonard. The kick out to Williams. Not going to go that time. Still a close game. Dallas leads by one. And we'll be back shortly for the start. Second quarter, fairly close game so far. And what do you think, guys, about Dallas here in this one?
Attacking, drawing fouls. They won that first quarter at the line.
Some people might feel they got some hometown calls, but when your team is pushing the often get the benefit of the doubt.
Here are the five the Clippers have to start the second. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Landry Shamet. Then there's Reggie Jackson. Then there's Patrick Patterson. And it's Williams at the shooting guard. For Dallas, they have taken 10 shots from the free throw line up to this point and made 6 of them.
And when you got a team percentage of about 81%, you're going to be one of the elites in this league.
Dallas leading by 3. Curry with it. Leonard picks him up. Powell dishes to Doncic. Outside Hardaway. Clock at six. Some solid defense there from Jackson. Williams finds Leonard, shoots over Curry, and it's Leonard missing. For Dallas, they've gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Hardaway against Jackson. Curry passes to Powell. Hardaway with it. Now Curry. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Rockets in Houston.
He was very active on defense, too, recording 3 steals for the game.
Leonard, the pass to Shamet. Leonard draws the double. Clippers moving the ball around. Williams can't get it to go. Dallas leading by 3. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Well, Lou Williams won 6th man of the year for the 3rd time last season. He joined Kevin McHale and Detlef Schrempf as the only players to win the award in consecutive seasons. And with the most career points ever scored off the bench, maybe they should just name this award after him. Kevin?
David, I'm all for it. Thank you so much. And boy, is he in good company. You know, Steve, for teams that are already struggling big time, that's a sign that the ship is going to be difficult to turn the other way and get back on track.
I think, Kevin, body language and obviously what they're saying in the media, there are some teams, you watch them, guys hit a 3-point shot, they come, no one's up clapping, no one's communicating with each other. Those are the teams I think it's very hard to turn around.
Catching up on the changes for Dallas. Zingas is checked in for Cauley Stein. Maxi Kleba comes in for Dwight Powell. Dorian Finney-Smith checked in for Doncic. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Seth Curry. The Clippers shooting their 4th and 5th shots at the foul line in the game. And the first one at the line is good.
Well, you talk about someone who's an absolute piranha on defense, and that is Patrick Beverly. Gives you no room to get comfortable and is a thorn in his assignment side.
And Smitty with Beverly and his defense, it's not like he turns it on or off.
Nope, he's always going full speed on defense. It's been his calling card as a player for years now. And it's what he's made his name on in the NBA.
Hardaway against George. Over Hardaway. And the Clippers miss again. Dallas leading by 7. Here's Finney-Smith. Sweet little floater. Finney-Smith's got 6 points.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Beverly finds George. Takes a 3. That one misses. And it's Dallas the other way. Following this game, they hit the road to challenge the Suns. Start off a 3-game road trip for the team. Clippers trail by 9. Out of bounds, Dallas will take possession. And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for Porzingis.
And the biggest takeaway when you look at his numbers is how good his 3-point shooting has been the past 5 games. He's finding the open spots on the perimeter, and when he's getting good looks, boy, he is not missing.
Here's Brunson, and he can't extend the lead to double digits. Clippers have gotten off to a rough start here in the second quarter. 0-for-5, and the bucket is good. 3-point play chance here for him.
Grant, body control and focus. Kawhi showing it all right there.
Well, you knew that Kawhi Leonard would be a huge name in the free agency market last summer, especially after winning his 2nd Finals MVP.
And Kawhi let the pieces fall before making his decision. Was the last major free agent to choose where he was going to play. Ended up shaking up the NBA in the process by joining the Clippers.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. and bought out by his hometown Knicks. Nice to see Joakim Noah back in action once again.
It is. A former Defensive Player of the Year, a two-time All-Star. His passion is never in question.
And both free throws good for Porzingis. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. George against Hardaway. Launches a three, and it's George missing.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Here's Brunson. It's through for a second basket. He's now 2 for 6.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
And this is what happens when you start to break your opponent's spirit. The resistance is no longer there.
And here's Leonard from three. It's rebounded by Dallas.
And just not able to find the target from three-point range here in the second quarter, although he did knock down one in the first.
Knocks it loose. Down low. Noah. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's on Porzingis.
Noah has a little bit of a different release on his jump shot. That's the reason why he drew the foul.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
And just 72%. Greatest of numbers, but there are guys who are far worse off when it comes to free throw shooting.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Ivica Zubats has checked in for Leonard. And Morris subbed in for Jamichael Green. Noah hits them both.
Noah's one of those guys. He has a perfect blend of a guy who loves to play defense and loves to pass the basketball. He's unselfish.
To the inside. Here's Hardaway. Who's back up. And that's 2 points on the layup. Hardaway has got the lead up to 10 now for Dallas.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Beverly finds George. Over Hardaway. Here's Zubats. Banked in off the glass.
Relentless on the offensive glass, and then you love the finish.
Runs in the pass to Finney Smith. Outside, Porzingis. Now here's Brunson, defended by Beverly. Brunson, good.
And yeah, he's not messing around. He wants no part of a comeback in this one.
Reason why momentum can flip so quickly. We see it time and time again. Teams giving up big leads.
George looking over the floor. Clock at four. Zubac kicks to George. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And another miss. Ooh. He's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right.
Great defensive effort, just saved a basket.
You know what? This is why you never give up on a play. You don't know what's going to happen.
Plus the harm.
Well, Steve, it's expected that we'll eventually allow 18-year-olds to enter the NBA draft. A proud Michigan State alum. Are you concerned players may miss something by choosing to skip the college experience?
You know, Kevin, in this situation, for sure, there are some players that I would say is going to make some mistakes and maybe come out too early and not be ready. But I think we have to allow them to have these decisions and not have these decisions taken away from them. I love college, but there are some guys that are just ready to go play in the NBA, just like other areas of life. When you're ready, you're ready.
Cleveland. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
The D just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
It's a backbreaker for your defense, giving up easy buckets like that.
Williams can't get it to go.
He's been scoreless for a while now. They're still trailing here. They might want to move to some other options offensively.
Here's Beverly. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Beverly's got 6 points in the quarter.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into it.
And the dunk by Porzingis.
And how about breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more. You're right. And the pass to Morris. It's rebounded by Dallas. Kleba's got 7 rebounds in the game. Here's Porzingis, and the dunk by Porzingis.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Outside, George. Looking to get back on track here. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Well, for so much of what Paul George brings to the table, defensive impact. He is one of the top defenders in the league at his position, if not the best.
Catching up on the changes for Dallas. Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Porzingis. Ipao comes in for Maxi Kleba. Doncic is checked in for Hardaway. And it's Seth Curry in for Jalen Brunson. Powell dishes to Cauley-Stein. Here's Doncic. A three-pointer is right on target. Doncic has got 12. You look at George with all he does, Greg, you sometimes forget how good his perimeter defense is.
Well, I mean, his teammates and coaches won't ever forget about the impact he has on that end. Even when George isn't scoring or the shot isn't falling, he is still a monster on the floor just with his defense alone.
And the Clippers call time here.
Top of the list. And it boils down to the question. Toughness. One team showing it, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Joakim Noah, he's checked in for Zubac. Leonard comes in for Morris. Landry Shamet's checked in for George. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Reggie Jackson. And he jams it with authority.
They just won't miss. I mean, this is incredible.
Good shooting can be contagious. You see the confidence running through this team right now.
Leonard draws the double. Here's Noah. Powell pulls it in. Powell's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead. And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Beverly, the pass to Leonard. Free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
Comfortable inside, plus the 7'3" wingspan. Hard to stop Kawhi without fouling.
He's shooting free throws, number 4 in 5 here.
In their last contest, guys, he was unconscious from the foul line.
So he hits 1 of 2 from the stripe. No one near Curry as he lets it go. No good with the triple. Clippers trail by 16. Over in the corner, Beverly. From the arc, that's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Beverly's got 9 points now in the quarter.
That's what they expect from Patrick Beverly, knocking down the spot-up Jay.
Here's Doncic. Joakim Noah grabs the miss. The Clippers shooting around 36%. They're just not able to finish consistently.
Oh, that's a major league throwdown.
Keeps a tight grip on that rim, too, after the finish. To Cauley-Stein. Doncic right side. Dallas again missing. And so is Dallas holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to
the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back. It is checking out Dallas. And big fella, let's get your thoughts on the home team.
Well, it was an unselfish, team-oriented half of basketball. The ball never stopped moving. Their offense had a great flow to it, preventing anyone from getting lazy.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
The second half upon us. We'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Kawhi, all over this one.
Definitely.
the move, forcing the action, getting to his spots, and finishing plays.
While we've got a moment, let's up the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. On the floor for Dallas, Doncic out there with Jalen Brunson. And there's Porzingis, and it's Kleba in at the four spot. And perhaps the most shocking news of the NBA offseason, Greg, the trade of Paul George. Nobody saw that coming.
Took a ransom of draft picks to get him off the Thunder. Kawhi Leonard recruited him to join him on the Clippers, and Paul obliged by demanding the trade. Came together quickly and caused a major power shift in the West.
His inability to make shots has not brought this team down. That shows you their resourcefulness.
An efficient score inside. Morris can beat you with a variety of moves.
George against Doncic. Passes it to Porzingis. And the dunk by Porzingis.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
Knocked loose. Doncic with the steal. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
And great steal and look ahead there. Compared to most guys his age, Doncic sees the game at another level.
Steve, I know you like this, that the three-point shot is having such an effect on the league, actually transforming the NBA. Are you surprised how fast all this is happening?
I am. I'm surprised that so many teams are adopting this transformation of shooting a three-ball, because there are some teams and there's some players, I know they shoot it, Kevin, but they shoot it at such a low percentage. If you have the guys that can shoot it, you should adopt it. If not, you got to find another way of winning ball games. There's nothing wrong with having a great mid-range team that can knock down mid-range jumpers.
And it just seems when Doncic turns it on, it's a sight to see. Incredible at scoring in a variety of ways.
Here's George. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. Los Angeles, they have made 9 free throws in the game, 14 attempts.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
And George drops them both. Dallas leading by 11. Pass to Kleba. And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Six to shoot. And the rejection by Leonard.
Strong instincts and positioning. Kawhi read that shot all the way.
They grabbed their own miss. And there's the bucket. Stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Leonard's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for Los Angeles. Doncic passes to Kleba. Right side, Porzingis. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. He'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
I love that they're continuing to attack despite being up big.
I'm impressed with their intensity tonight. They've came in focused, and they've executed.
George against Doncic. Porzingis with the block.
And with his length, Porzingis can be very disruptive on D. Not easy to get the shot off over that huge frame. Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
On the wing, George, guarded by Doncic.
He just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam. And so it's Brunson with it. He brings it up for Dallas. Outside, Porzingis. Lays it up and banks it in. Porzingis has got 7 points for the quarter.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Here's Leonard. Bucket is good.
Man, he keeps doing his part. They just haven't been able to get over the hump.
Dallas leading by 12. The pass to Brunson. For Porzingis with the ball. Kicks it to Doncic. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Doncic has got 9 points here in the second half. Now here's Beverly. He's covered closely. That's tipped.
And not exactly quick off the floor, but Luka uses great anticipation to make defensive plays.
On the wing, George. Headed by Porzingis. George, no good.
Well, not really his best quarter as far as scoring, but let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Poke loose. Finney Smith gets to Brunson. Pass to Doncic. Shoots over Zubats. They get it again.
Porzingis enabled to pad his stats a little bit there on that play. The board and the
bucket. And you know, Greg, that'll put him in the good graces of that coaching staff, too. My goodness. Kicks it out to Leonard. Leonard draws the double. Passes to Brunson. A three from Porzingis. The shot off that time.
And the Clippers will come the other way.
Leonard attacking. That falls. Nice feed that time from George. 27 points for Kawhi Leonard.
The power, the length, the ability to finish.
Timeout.
Leonard dominant in that painted area.
Dallas calls timeout. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible. You're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
Catching up on the changes for Dallas. Willie Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Porzingis. Ty Powell comes in for Maxi Kleber. Hardaway's checked in for Dorian Finney-Smith. And Curry subbed in for Jalen Brunson.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yes, let's look on the bright side. You got a great look. It's a play that you might want to go back to again.
Jackson from long range. It's rebounded by Doncic. Doncic has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Here's Hardaway. That shot, no good. Clippers trail by 14. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Outside Curry. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That's on Joakim Noah.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
So he gets them both.
He's living there tonight, a tough guy to guard without fouling. And the bonus, he's going to knock him down.
Williams attacking, lays it up off the glass.
The thing about Lou Williams, he sort of glides around, then suddenly he hits the turbo jets.
And here is Doncic, who's got 23.
Lou Williams has been a weapon off the bench for so long, and he has won 6th Man of the Year multiple times.
Outside Hardaway. That 3 off the mark.
Okay, that's frustrating. You work hard to get these open looks. You know he liked that one back.
Pass to Shamet. Williams against Doncic. Launches it. Yep, it goes. And the Dallas lead is cut down to 11 on the bucket from Lou Williams. And for Lou Williams, he is just instant offense when you bring him Smitty into the game.
And a lot of that is just his mindset. Lou Williams, once he's checked in, he is attacking at every given opportunity. Not everyone can be successful off the bench, but Lou Williams has made a career of it.
He kicks to Jackson. Williams against Doncic. 6 on the shot clock. Pulls it up. That's it, and the Dallas lead is cut down now to just 9 on the basket from Lou Williams.
so it's Dallas with it. The pass to Carly Stott. Some nice passing here by Dallas.
Good.
Los Angeles has gone 1-4 in three-point shots here in the third. Williams dishes to Jackson. And the dunk by Jackson.
Quick off his feet, the long arms, easy jam for Jackson.
Here's Curry. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12 and a half points a game. Pass to Cauley Stott. Here's Hardaway. Pass to Cauley Stott. Down to five on the shot clock. From deep three-point range, Doncic, no good.
Hasn't been able to dial it in from distance. He has just the 1-3, and that was in the first half.
Williams against Doncic. For the three. The shot by Williams, no good. Dallas leading by 9. Tries it from 19. Rebounded by Jackson. Williams looking around. 40 seconds left in the third. Out left to the wing. Noah kicks to Williams. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Luka Doncic. That'll be his second foul of the game. That's good from the... Marcus Morris has checked in for Landry Shamet. Just three to shoot. Jackson from long range. It's rebounded by Dallas. Cauley Stein's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Here's Hardaway. It's hauled in by Noah. Noah's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Curry against Jackson. Fires the 3. Good that time. And offensively, a great show for the fans through the first 3 quarters. It's been a fun game to watch. It's Dallas, up 8. And we're just... And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
Decision making right there. He showed both, and he did so at a very high level.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth and final quarter. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the fourth, they've got Ivica Zubac. Williams is out there with Reggie Jackson. Then it's Marcus Morris, and it's George in at the small forward.
Yeah, you see the athleticism George had on that dunk. It's so quick and explosive. Gets to the rim in an instant.
Curry passes to Doncic. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Doncic has got 11 points here in just the second half.
Yeah, he's in such a great rhythm right now. Makes sense to get him the ball any way you can.
Let him decide whether to shoot it, whether to pass it. He's your catalyst right now.
Hardaway against George. Over Hardaway. George, no good.
Decent look from mid-range, but there may have been a better option for them in that set.
Powell. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. And now it's a 10-point Dallas lead.
One sign of a great playmaker hitting his man in stride.
Williams against Doncic. On the wing, Williams. Off target from outside. Dallas leading by 10. And Doncic gets it to go. Doncic has got 4 points now in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Williams trying to break free. A nice shot by George.
After a lackluster first half, he's taken charge offensively. We'll see how the defense responds.
And it's Curry with the ball, bringing it up for Dallas. 17 points was their biggest margin. Dallas calls timeout.
And as fans and broadcasters, we're not permitted to hear the specifics in these huddles.
No, we're left to infer from the adjustments we see on the floor.
Comes in for Dwight Powell. Dorian Finney-Smith checked in for Tim Hardaway Jr. And it's Jalen Brunson in for Luka Doncic. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, I heard Rick Carlisle during that last break talking with the team. He told them, this is a game of runs. It's a game of momentum. We may have the lead now, but I'm telling you guys, it can evaporate in a hurry. Let's close this thing out. Kevin?
That free throw, no good. Second free throw, good.
And good job bringing that free throw percentage up here in the second half, doing a great job at the line.
Outside Leonard. Three-pointer. It's rebounded by Dallas.
But still, eventually you got to feel like he'll start knocking those down again.
They get it back. And there's the call on Patrick Beverly. That is his first foul of the game. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone.
Not his best game, but they're still getting it done collectively.
Here's Porzingis. Well, it was only a matter of time that they finally get the bucket.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
The aggressive approach. Leonard pushing the action, rewarded with the foul call.
And he sinks the second.
And one of the problems in the first half, that shoddy work at the free throw line. They needed to fix that, and they've been much improved since the break.
Patterson against Curry. Got a piece of it.
Just a great job of timing on the block from Patterson.
Shot clock at 6. Here's Finney-Smith. And it's Patterson with the rebound. Leonard attacking. There's the dish to George. Let's it go with the 3. Porzingis with the rebound. Porzingis has got 9 rebounds in the game. He's getting it done. And there's the call on Patrick Beverly. That's foul number 2 for him. Los Angeles on D. A 12-point game. Up top, Porzingis. And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. That's foul number 2 for him.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
Brunson scanning the floor. Kleba gets the 3-pointer to fall. And Dallas leads by 15.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
On the wing, George, guarded by Kerr. Here's Kevin Gillen. And again, it's the Clippers missing.
And I'm sure next time he sits down, coach is going to have a few choice words for him with that shot selection.
And you know what? He knows it. You have to try to play within the system or you're going to come away with empty.
And the work they've done at the line has been impressive here in the second half.
Zubac is checked in for the Clippers. Marcus Morris comes in for Patrick Patterson.
Well, a lot of progress being made from a technical standpoint. You can't escape it, Steve. Shoes now that can tighten themselves without laces, changing colors. Have you gotten yourself a pair yet?
Well, Kevin, I have. pair for my kids. I do like these type of shoes where there are no shoelaces. I'm a little lazy right now, Kevin, but I love the technology that are going into shoes right now. Talented, driven, he puts constant pressure on your defense.
And it's Leonard missing. Leonard with the steal. Beverly, the pass to Leonard. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. Tries again, and he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. Leonard's got 30 points. Now here's Brunson, defended by Beverly. Now here's Brunson, trying to break that ice-cold streak. 20 that time from Leonard.
And his pure defensive effort changed that shot from an easy one to a tough one.
And you know, technically, it's a high percentage look, but this is why we play the game.
Brunson, no good. Porzingis with the steal. They shoot again. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Zubats has got 6 rebounds now in the game. Ahead. That's it, and the Dallas lead is cut to just 11 points in the basket from Paul George.
You know, as ice cold as he was in the first half, that's how since the break. No one can match up with him right now.
Porzingis against Zubats. Porzingis is double. Here's Finney-Smith. Traps in the tray. And Dallas leads by 14.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Beverly for three. And Curry pulls it down. Curry's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Pass to Brunson. Here's Finney-Smith, defended by Beverly. No good from Finney-Smith. Clippers trail by 14. Here's George, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Well, if it's a Zubats, may not block a lot of shots, but Smitty, he is still a solid defender.
What Zubats does is a great job of challenging players at the rim and provides great help from the weak side. He does rack up a lot of defensive fouls, but hopefully that decreases with time.
Now here's Brunson, defended by Beverly. Porzingis kicks to Kleba. And there's the pass to Brunson. Shot clock at 5. Shoots it. Kept alive. Kleba. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. First free throw is good.
And one difference this half is that when they get to the line, they're converting.
And so he hits both.
Because he knows he makes a living at the line. He invites contact and sometimes even initiates it.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
And he could tell his guys starting. Call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Luka Doncic.
And guys, he's been about as close to perfection as you can be. The intensity he's played with has been amazing. Just no let up. And as fired up as he's been, he's never let his emotions get out of control.
He sure has given this crowd a treat tonight. This kind of performance only cements his status as a fan favorite. Poked away. Porzingis with the steal. Brunson the pass to Porzingis. And there's the call on Patrick Beverly. That's his 3rd foul so far. Bonus situation.
And just not nearly as effective at drawing fouls on the defense as he was in that first half.
And the Clippers making a change here. Williams. Leonard attacking. Can't get it to fall. Dallas leading by 16. Outside, Porzingis. The shot misses, so Los Angeles will take it the other way. Morris outside. It's George on the wing. Brunson covering for 3. Williams and Zubats
So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two. Dallas has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. And there's the call on Lou Williams. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two. And he knocks down the first one. And he makes both free throws. And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Clippers. Down by 15. 1:41 left in the fourth. Porzingis with the steal, and Zubac picks up the foul. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two. He doesn't get the second one. Clippers trail by 16. Left side, George, and he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
And a breakthrough season for Marcus Morris in 2018 and 19. Career highs almost across the board.
You know, Green, the Celtics are encouraging their players to take mental health just as seriously as their physical health. Marcus Morris, brave enough to say that that helped him a lot.
I mean, the Morris twins growing up in the hard streets of Philly, I mean, a lot to overcome. But by getting some help, that's exactly what Marcus is doing.
Dallas leading by 14.
And these are the types of games where one team clearly has the edge. Tonight, it will be a win by a large margin for Dallas.
You know, a team can have a great shooting night without getting a lot of assists, but tonight they had both.
Yeah, hey, listen, you only get the assist if the guy you give it to makes the shot. So a lot of assists will up your field goal percentage, but this is a great team effort by everyone.
And an important milestone for them tonight as they pick up win number 10.
And this is a great way for them to kick off this season series. Two more games ahead, and they've taken the mental advantage with this win tonight.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys, and looking at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Porzingis.
You know what stood out to me was the anticipation defensively. He sensed what the offense wanted to run, then found ways to disrupt that and cause turnovers.
Williams for three. It's rebounded by Porzingis. This one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. And we'll see you next time.